Oh my God. Are we, please tell me we're rolling on this. This is great content.
I'm trying to name the puppy now. That's the stage we're at as we welcome you to the Rubber Boots podcast. You wrote me stuff. Do you have a name for the puppy?
Oh, I have the perfect name. Do you want to go through some of the listener ones first? Or?
Sure. Why don't we do that? Hello, Lester. Hello, Puffy. Puffy's just back from a nice family walk.
Family walk, family hike.
Oh, where'd
nice.
You go?
Ooh, nice.
We went to a park, like a ravine area near my house.
Is that legal?
Sounds safe.
It's legal.
Yeah, you
it's
can
legal.
To, you know, I guess the public parks. You can't go on like the little tilt-a-whirls or what are those things called? Those spinny things?
Yeah. You can't go on the like parks with
play
like,
apparatus.
Yeah.
Did you mean merry-go-round? By the way.
Oh, you know the thing in the parks though that you spin.
Yeah. You spin. They're one death traps.
One of my favorite moments from high school, my buddy Mark Tadiello, who's was my best man at my wedding, and him and Mark Ward the three of us always hung out, and Tad had these kind of bulging eyes, and he was completely hammered one night, and we were, you know, as high schoolers do, we were drinking in this park, and we kept spinning the wheel, and he was too dizzy, so he was trying to stop us, so we were spinning as fast as we could, and then he'd grab a hold of it, and it would send him like flying like 20 feet. Jeff O'Neill is calling, everyone. Just a second. Hey, Jeff, how are you?
Buddy, I know we're kind of all a little bit stir crazy, but I have one question for you, and it's kind of weird, but did the spider kill the f-ing snake, or what happened? Like, did the...
Oh, you're. We're actually taping the pod right now. Lester, Puffy, and Christoph are here.
I don't care.
But I tweeted a video, a nature video of a spider. Did you guys see this? Cap
no.
Eating a snake. Cap the spider, little spider captures the snake. And you're saying,
Jimmy,
I don't know if
the spider killed the snake though.
The spider, yeah, you can eat it. Spiders can eat, I'm going to Google it right now. Gustav, can you Google, can a spider eat a snake?
I'm on it.
Ants, look at how small the spider is. Where is he going to put it?
Well, he could take little pieces of it.
Snakes eat like cows. They're way smaller.
Puffy says that a snake can eat a cow. So if a snake can eat a cow, then a spider can eat a snake.
So a tarantula can eat a snake, it says here.
No.
Digestive enzymes.
Hold on a second.
The little spider can't eat a snake. The snake is 4 feet long.
Hold on. No, look it. I have an article from The Independent. Photos show ambitious red-black spider eating deadly snake in Australia. And this is not the same video, but it's got a picture, that I'm going to have to send you. And the spider is, like, on top of the snake now, like, sucking up part of its body.
Yeah, so. Well, I'm not buying it. Like, the little spider can't eat the giant snake. Like,
is that all you had for today?
Little spider's going to take giant I guess for the next 4 years. Anyway, I gotta go. I have to work.
That was guest appearance by Jeff O'Neill.
Oh no.
That's so that gives all of you three and our audience a pretty good idea of what Jeff and my phone calls are like every day, because he calls every day with something like that.
Oh my God!
Did you actually see that post?
I didn't see it.
I have not.
Okay, so
that's on Twitter. You said?
Well, you know, I'll just show it to you on the screen here because we're on the doing the Skype thing here, and you guys can all watch it together. So I decided to start posting nature videos, and got the spider's got the snake. You can go onto my Twitter account, listeners, and try to follow along at home. I posted this on Monday, if you're listening to this later in the week.
And
so is that like it looks like a garden snake?
No, it's apparently a I don't know, some sort of poisonous snake. Either way, the comments on this are quite accurate. Like, you got to burn down that garage, don't you?
You got to do something.
Okay, so I'm only reading my replies, so I'm thinking if it's smart people that are smarter than us. It's a red-black spider killing a juvenile eastern Sydney brown snake. Second deadliest spider in the world, killing the third deadliest snake. Both exist around a city of 5.5 million people, Sydney. No one ever dies. There you go. That's from Sean Kay, who's not probably a listener to the podcast, but...
he will be now.
I could see that being... a pretty good show, like a TV show, having like deadly creatures from different species battle to the death.
Hey,
on Murder Island 2.
Wow,
this Murder Island or animal.
You know what? Jeff O'Neill's got to be a panelist on that show. There's no doubt about it. I'd say host, but you know, we know
people are disturbed by this video. Bonk's Mullet, who's a very funny hockey follow. He replied to me, I like to think he put a little saddle on it and rode it around like a pony. I don't think that's what happened.
Wow.
I also posted a nature video before that, since we're on the topic, of a sea angel hovering under ice in Russia. This is what it's come to in my life. Look at this thing. Look at our world.
Wow.
This is horrible podcasting. Please go to my Twitter account.
Yeah.
It's an actual creature. See?
That's insane. Real thing.
I've decided, guys, that I'm only going to post nature videos now until hockey returns.
It's a good move.
Okay. Well, maybe this week.
Is it true
maybe.
That like, animals are like now running the cities? They're like cougars are flying through downtown parts. And it's like the animals are like, this is like the best year ever.
Wait a second. Cougars are flying?
Wild shit's happening.
Have we gone true sci-fi?
Cougars? You didn't realize that they can fly now?
I didn't want to say anything. I have heard more definitely things like coyotes are making more appearances,
right?
For sure. I haven't seen anything else, but I would imagine Africa is a little bit different now. And by the way, they're having a very hard time right now. So,
Well, they got the locusts, as we talked about. Beyond that,
yes, exactly.
You're going through this crap, and then you got these giant locusts that we've talked about previously on the pod. The terrifying.
I know.
Where the hell were we? Oh, the puppy.
Correct.
Right.
Look, it all comes together. Deadly snakes, animals, locusts, flying cougars, puppy names. We were going to play some of the play, like there's a recording. We were going to mention some of the other puppy names being suggested on the Twitter. I'm getting a third puppy. If you missed the last couple of episodes, I gave into that. I posted a picture of the puppy. Pretty cute puppy, eh, guys?
It looks like a pig.
It looks like a pig?
Yeah, it looks like a little pig.
Well, that's what all French bulldogs kind of look like, pigs.
I thought he looked more like a flying cougar.
let's see. Carlos Bernandez, I sent you guys this one. If this puppy isn't called Emilio, I don't know why we're even here.
Very good point.
Solid one.
That's the name, Emilio.
I can't. My family, I tried to throw Emilio at them. Like, I'm going to get outvoted on this thing. I have three women in my house and a son and when I all the funny ones I suggest, they don't go for. You know,
what do they want to name?
Well, I wanted to name it Help. So like it's out in the backyard at night and you go, Help! Help! I came up with that on my own because somebody said name it Stay. And so you go, come here, stay. Come here, stay.
Oh God.
Confuse the dog.
Or Fire? Fire!
Oh God.
That would be great for one day. And then the cops would show up.
A couple of people suggested the evil Whizmaster. The evil Whizmaster got a couple of votes. I'm never naming anything after the Quizmaster.
No.
Anything else in their stuff? Did you see any others?
No, for me, Emilio was the clear runaway winner. I do have my own suggestion.
All right. Well, let me go through some of the family suggestions so you guys can go. Oh, Bogart. Somebody suggested Bogart, and you can still call it Bo. Oh, and which my wife wants to call it Bo.
Bo?
She does?
Bogey?
She likes
Bogey.
Bo. And I could think of that because I could say a name that after Bo Jackson, you know?
Yeah.
Bo Jackson, not bad.
I want to name it. I want to have an athlete name. There's no other. There's no other ones that I see here. So other family names. So some of them want to call it Rory, which again I could live with because I like Rory McIlroy, but that's not the reason for it.
Oh, is he some dreamy guy in a WB show?
No, I think that they, because we live in Aurora, they wanted to call it Aurora, and Rory is short for Aurora.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, Trey. I like the name Trey. Kind of a boys' hood name. Lester? Yeah. Trey? Third dog?
I got the name for you.
Third dog, Trey?
I suggested Bane last week.
Mm-hmm.
That was wrong.
Okay.
I should have said Son of Bane. That would have been way better.
S.O.B.? Son of Bane?
S.O.B.
I want to give it a full name, like Tim Raines. Hey, Tim Raines, come on, let's go out for a pee.
Well, that seems a little...
I don't know.
I'm sure Tim will appreciate it.
What about Kawhi?
Well, what if he leaves after a year?
He can only have him for a year, is that the deal?
He just takes off for the coast.
Well, you see, we got our last dog after we came back from Hawaii, and they wanted to call it Kauai after the island Kauai. So I say, just call it Kauai, but I'll call it Kauai with a W.
Right.
All right, stop. Yeah. Call the puppy.
All right, so we were looking for something that's masculinely cutesy, and I've come up with the perfect name, Puffy.
Yeah, exactly.
We called the dog Puffy. And in terms of content for the pod, we'll have all kinds of great clips of you saying, Puffy, stop humping my leg. Puffy ate out of the garbage again. And so on. The rest writes itself.
Puffy's licking his balls again.
We already had that one.
Oh, you're not going to believe this. Puffy all over my bed.
It has happened one time before.
It's got merit there, Stoff.
It's not bad. It's not something.
I'm now just noticing that Stoff has a dog in his background.
Stoff has got the Bill Belichick draft shot in the background when Belichick left the scene, and his dog, Nike, who looks like a husky, took the seat.
Me and Bill are good friends.
It's a real shame that we're not on YouTube and people can't see Stoff's background every week because it's one of the highlights of the podcast.
Bill's house looked kind of modest from what I would have
seen. Extremely modest.
Like it looked like a quaint two-bedroom, 900 square foot home. Like it did not.
I'm watching The Wire right now. I'm finally into it, Stoff. By the way, I love it.
Awesome.
And this looks like it's something out of the projects in The Wire.
Yeah, like it does not. Like, you have that Cliff Kingsbury, and his house is, like, cribs. It's, like, the most kick-ass bachelor pad you could imagine. And he's had the job 1 year. Belichick's been grinding for, like, 30, won 6 bowls, and he's living in, like, a 2-bedroom startup home.
But maybe in order to replace Brady, he's selling off so that he has more money to recruit free agents. Mm-hmm.
Could it be, though, he's just superstitious? He's been successful. Why change anything? Could be.
Yeah.
You know?
Look, Warren Buffett lives in the same house, right? He's lived in for like 30 years. The guy's one of the richest men on the planet, so there's something to it.
True.
I, on the other hand, will always buy a solid $1 million over what I can afford.
That's a good rule to live by.
And the only thing in trouble, Jimmy, is if there's some kind of global pandemic.
You need the space for your golf net.
The packages keep coming to the door. So one comes the other day, and I can't remember precisely what it was, but it was like a tray or something. And I'm like, what's this for? She goes, oh, for entertaining. I'm like, entertaining? There's going to be no entertaining. Entertaining is dead.
Is it an online tray?
There's no entertaining for like the next 2 years. We're not going to entertain.
But it's like you're talking about a platter with something you would serve?
Yes.
Yes. Oh, my God. Wow. Does it come with a 6-foot arm? You can go.
Big extension.
Big extensions. Like a selfie stick.
That's $1 million idea.
Well, while we're talking about the annoying visuals that we can see that our audience can't, Lester's going, I've got it's like a sleeveless, he's looking pretty funky again today.
Just jacked.
Brother, you know, I'm just trying to stay comfortable here and
You've changed your background. What's going on at the left side of your screen? It looks like a massage table.
It is a massage. It's a massage. It's like a sitting massage thing. Yeah.
So that's where you lie down and your blow up doll massages.
Shh, I'm working on it.
Wait a second, though. Seriously, who's giving you the massage there? Because you're in quarantine.
Well, I'm well, yeah. Look, here's what happened. You know that place called Closeout King? Yeah. I saw this.
By your rebounder?
I said, no.
You got a 3-for-1 deal? You got a blow up doll, a rebounder, and a massage table?
You know what? Wow. I'm done. I can't take this abuse anymore.
No, go
here
ahead.
It is. All these things are trying to keep me in an optimal shape and looking good and feeling good, and I get abuse. Everybody.
Oh, you look great. You look amazing.
I feel pretty good. No, I bought this thing. It's like $50 at Closeout King. It was crazy. I just cleaned it up, and I've got it now. At the time, I was with someone, but quite frankly, sometimes when I can't sleep, I'll sit down on this and put my head in, and I'm out. It's great. It's a good way to sleep ergonomically.
What?
You go to bed in your massage?
I don't know. No, I can't even show you. Can I?
No, just move your camera.
Okay, look.
I know what you're talking about. So
it's like
those things at the airport, right?
Oh yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, so you're sitting down, you put your head down, and they give you a little massage at the airport for $10.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. They're awesome.
It's great.
Great for getting an airport massage, but not for going to bed.
I'm just saying, if sometimes I've been this, or you got a cold. Let's say you got a cold, right?
Yeah.
And you're all stuffed up. You go like this, and you. I've slept like that. Not for very long, but you know,
it's more comfortable than a neti pot.
Yeah. What else you got in that apartment there, Lester?
I have many things, in fact.
Yeah, Lester's apartment should be a show. Lester's apartment? What's inside Lester's apartment?
It's actually a townhouse, so you know I've got a little more room for these things, so that's why.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Everything's cool.
If there's a lady at the bar, would you like to come back to my townhouse?
I have a rebounder, a massage chair, and many leather-bound books.
And I'm going to put on my sleeveless vest. So I guess all vests are sleeveless.
That's a fair point.
Yeah, that would be correct, Jimmy.
Sorry. Let's go through some of the stuff Stoff had here on the... he had some infomercial talk. I think, Stoff, maybe you should be doing the introductions here. You got to thinking, I guess, this week after we had our great-looking hair clip from Ronco.
Yeah, that was something. So the name Ronco rang a bell for me, and I remember there was the Ronco rotisserie that they had, and the main thing I remember from this, there was two things. There was they had a slogan that was set it and forget it. Like, you could set this thing and just walk away. Which I always found was kind of weird because, you know, it could start like a house fire.
So, like, put the pig on it and just leave for a few hours?
Yeah, like, you literally set it for 4 hours to, you know, on the rotisserie and you just go about your day.
Sounds fantastic.
Convenient, but at what price? And then in the middle of the infomercial, there was the guy Ron, I guess, and he, in order to prove the rotisserie's durability, he would nail it with a hammer. So that was the one image that
stuck
out for me.
Wait a second, he nailed the meat?
No, the actual rotisserie while the meat was in there rotating.
Wow.
Oh, God.
I don't remember that spot at all.
Well, you're missing out, Lester. So speaking of Ronco products, I have a list here if you want me to go through them, because it's interesting. They made a hair product and then a rotisserie. Amongst those things, there's the Chop-O-Matic, which is a handheld food processor.
Now, that's not the one with the guy, the infomercial guy there, the guy that ended up
You're thinking of the Slap Chop.
Oh, Slap Chop. Okay. So something like
that. This was like the early Slap
Chop. He also did the ShamWow, by the way.
Yes.
That same guy.
Edit point. So like I was saying, the Pocket Fisherman, which was a small fishing pole, they also had a microphone which you could transmit the radio, a egg scrambler.
Oh, Mr. Microphone I bought. I think I had one of those.
You should be podcasting on that thing.
Yeah, that's when I was still dreaming of being a broadcaster.
Wow.
Sing around the house.
Mr. Microphone. I wonder if we could get a better reach if we use that one. There was a 20-piece cutlery set from Ronco. A
pie cutlery set?
a pie cutlery set.
Oh, I think that was supposed to be peace. I may have just typed that out wrong.
Just take that. Buff sends us a list of his suggestions beforehand, so I'm trying to read along. And I thought it was a pie cutlery set, which sounded a lot more fun.
It would have been.
Because how many pieces of cutlery could you use for one pie?
Exactly.
Maybe that's something we should come up with.
You need no more than 7 pieces of pie cutting cutlery in your house. Sell me, baby, sell me.
Sell me, you beautiful bastard, sell me. I need 4 different sizes of spoons for this lemon meringue.
I mean, you guys are joking. I guarantee you there's something like that out there already.
Oh, for sure.
Brooksy's probably bought it already.
Yeah, so an automatic pasta maker, and then there was the rhinestone stud setter, which kind of...
Right, what was that thing again?
I don't know. I guess you put rhinestone studs into things.
Like in Lester's desk or something like that, you'd put it, right?
Yeah. That's actually a great idea.
Yeah.
And transition over to country.
Like a rhinestone cowboy. Does
Ronco still exist?
Oh, I mean, after inventing all these products, I imagine he's just sitting back somewhere, kicking, relaxing. But
this sounds like a
hell of money.
So was Ronco was Ron?
I think the guy who owned it was Ron. Let me just...
And he just invented crap?
Yeah.
It'd be a fun company to work for. Just come with the wildest. Wasn't that an age like the 70s or 80s where inventions were the thing, right? Just come.
100%.
When we were kids, all we wanted to do was invent shit.
Yeah, it was Ron Popeil. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but the company's defunct as of 2018. So they were going at it until 2018.
What killed Ronco? I want to see the Netflix doc.
Oh, maybe that's something I should work on.
I think it was Carol Baskin. I think she killed him too.
You know what?
Killed Bronco and fed it to the tiger.
I thought it was the stud setter, but
I looked it up, guys. This Bronco, I looked it up. He lives next to Belichick. True story. They're starting a new company, Bilco. Okay, I gotta go.
Don't you have to go on a call?
That was so quiet.
I think Sean Redmond's calling.
Stop! Oh, you gotta put in the cricket sound there. A little cricket drop.
You don't have to put anything in there.
I think the cricket sound was already there, but
I'm good. Sorry.
It was natural.
Oh man. All
right. Johnny Carson. Ew, little bubble.
Let's do
Oh, hold on, guys. I'm reading up here on the downfall of the Mr. Microphone. Do you guys want to hear about this?
Yeah.
Sure.
Why not?
So apparently there was an ad where a young man drove by some ladies and used the microphone to say, "Hey, good looking, we'll be back to pick you up later," over their radio. And it was basically it was looked as sexual misconduct. So
that was on the infomercial, right?
Yeah.
Was it? Yeah. You know what? As a matter of fact, there is a great Twitter follow who I've probably talked about on the show before called Super 70 Sports.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I follow him too.
I am pretty sure that sometime in the last 2 weeks that he tweeted that soundbite from that Mr. Microphone infomercial.
Hey, good looking. We'll be back to pick you up later.
Because I remember laughing my ass off going, how could this be on television?
Well, that was wrong, Jimmy. And how come there isn't a Mrs. Microphone?
Oh, I think there is.
Ronco's sexist.
So they shut him down.
It just, don't you think if Ronco was in its heyday right now that Lester would have like 12 different things in his house? In his town?
I do like gadgets. I'm not going to lie to you.
Let's do a little thing we call Puffy's Hypotheticals.
Yo, 1, 2, 1, 2. Puffy's Hypotheticals, I'm messing with my mind. Puffy's Hypotheticals, what's gonna be this time? Puffy's Hypotheticals, I'm blowing my mind again.
This is left over from last week. The Chicago Bulls had a Puffy's hypothetical. Was it on there? Where did they just tweet it?
Yeah, they so I guess with the whole Jordan doc going on, they jumped on the bandwagon and tweeted this out from their official Bulls account.
So you can go one-on-one with Jordan in his prime.
Yep.
You get 10 cracks. And if you score, you get $5 million. And if you don't score, you can never listen to music again. Do you go for it, Puffy?
No chance. Because Jordan's one of those people that is so competitive that he would actually take great pleasure in taking the gift of music away from someone. So he would actually try, and he would laugh at you and say, you can't listen to music, you loser. Like, if it was most athletes, even though they're way better, I think they'd be like, screw it, it's not my $5 million, I'll give it to him. But Jordan, and like probably Kobe would have been one. There's very few guys, but Jordan's one of them. He would be like, screw you, punk, you're getting nothing. He would ruin your life.
Lester?
I 100% agree with Puffy. Listen, I'm a musician. There's no way I put that on the line. I mean, that's going to give me, you know, probably more joy than $5 million throughout the course of my life. I would hope, anyway. But no, Jordan, he's absolutely right. Jordan was a extremely competitive guy. There's no way he's going to let some musician beat him.
I think that I'm tempted to go for it only because I would just shoot from outside on all 10 tries, because you have no chance to actually penetrate for a layup or anything or do anything. But, and he'd probably get right out on you knowing that. But if you just fired from, you know, 3-point range 10 times, do you think you'd make one?
Not with Jordan right in front of you.
Well, is there, okay, well, how does it start? When you're doing a one-on-one thing like that, is he like,
you gotta check the ball.
Check the ball.
Check
it. Yeah, so you check, and when you check the ball, he can be as close to you as he wants, right?
Well, he could check it and then come right on you.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think any of us are getting a shot off.
No.
Well, hold on. Let me ask you, it's a very important question to ask. Are we in a COVID era or post-COVID? Because in a COVID era.
Well, if he's got to give you 6 feet.
Right?
That's a very good point by you, Lester.
Good point,
Thank you
Lester.
Very much. I'm not just a hat rack.
See, I'm a little disappointed in you guys. It's as if none of you ever saw the Tanya Harding documentary.
Wow, what happened there?
Well, a tire iron, and all of a sudden the odds change.
Seriously, if there's no foul.
$5 million. I mean, when else would you ever have a shot at $5 million?
Yeah.
You got to take it.
Could you just kick him in the groin?
Yeah, or when you're checking the ball, you check it off his face.
Wow.
I don't know if I'd want an angry Michael Jordan now defending me.
Well, I have $5 million to...
Now, also, if it was Michael Jordan, like, today, like, maybe you would have a chance then.
Or even Wizards Jordan.
Isn't that... You know what? Listen, can we just talk about... I know we're... But talk about that just for a second. I honestly hate that he did that. I know why he did it, because he wanted to support his team. But honestly, leave it there. Like, when he took that shot in 98 and left it there, mm-hmm. Leave it there, man. Like,
yeah.
I don't know.
You know, I've probably talked about it before, but, and Lester, if this quarantine and the lack of sports goes on for 6 months, dig up this game and play it. It was Wizard Jordan's against the Raptors. One of my like 10 NBA play-by-play games of my life in Toronto, and Jordan missed a buzzer beater and the Raptors won. And it was still a big deal because it was Jordan, even though it was Wizards Jordan.
Yeah.
And I, you know, that's something I'll tell my grandkids that I got to call a Jordan game.
That game was 2001, and I'm sure I have it already as a classic game.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, I'm sure I do.
You use me, my call, or like ESPN's?
I think it was, I took the TSN call. I'm going to look it up. I'll.
What if Lester overdubbed your call?
I was like, I was proud of that call, except I screwed up about 3 other times in that game. But then the call, I was like.
Here he is, top of the key. How many times have we seen this? This one man, one moment.
Then the producer said, James, we're in a commercial still.
James, stop rehearsing.
Jordan for the win? No.
That game, I actually had one of my greatest embarrassment in basketball play-by-play. One of the little technical arts of play-by-play is you decide how much you want to use your eyes on live play and how much you want to use the screen. And in a sport like basketball, everybody uses their eyes. But in a sport like football, a lot of the play-by-play guys will use their monitor more than, especially if you're up really high. I think most guys still use what they actually see. But I learned doing CFL that you use your monitor more because, let's say with the virtual first down marker, you can look like an idiot if you're like, oh, it looks like he's a yard short. And then you look over at the screen and he's clearly past the yellow line, right? Sure, so you get fooled by that. But I got caught looking down at my monitor as the players were running by. And the monitor, TV is going the opposite way of where they're going in front of you when you're on the opposite court. And so I had the wrong team scoring, basically.
Oh, no.
And I looked up and I'm like, oh, excuse me, that was the Raptors with two, not the Wizards. Did you edit that part out?
2001, I would have ripped your ass so bad.
Thank God there was no Twitter back then.
Oh, God. Right. What the hell else is on here? Oh, you know what? I was thinking while you guys were talking hypotheticals, we were talking about the when Jeff called the snake and the spider, and we all hate snakes and spiders. If you had a choice, so in your townhouse, house, your Bill Belichick kitchen, let's say you can 10 deadly snakes or 10 deadly spiders. What are you taking? These are going to be in your house.
I would take the snakes.
Bigger,
so you know where they were. Spiders,
yeah, exactly. They'd be easier to track.
Spiders easier to kill, though.
Yeah.
Maybe you have to disproportionate. Maybe you have to go 50 deadly spiders to 10 deadly snakes.
But your question was either or.
Yeah.
Like, come on.
Yeah, either or.
Hold on.
How much money are you getting?
Les is getting obsessed.
I got a question. Can you take both?
Oh, so they eat each other.
Yeah. Well, we saw the video, right? Spiders get to work.
Would you take both?
Yeah, spiders eat the snakes. I get the vacuum cleaner for the spiders afterwards.
Wow.
Done deal.
I think this they're going to eat my puppy too, though, aren't they?
Oh, I can't let him get to little Tom over there.
I'm tempted to go with Puffy and take the snakes because you can find them at least.
Yeah.
You take a giant axe or something, I don't want to get PETA upset. I know snakes and all creatures are to be loved, but just not in my house.
No, exactly, not up in here. I got my massage chair, and that's it.
Yeah, like when an animal comes on your property, you're allowed to kill it, right?
Well, like I don't know about a squirrel. I think it's definitely against a bylaw to suffocate a raccoon in your green bin.
Or a possum.
Hypothetically.
Right.
Hypothetically.
How about if said I was able to do that with a skunk? Would that also be hypothetically wrong?
I think it would. Think.
Are you luring these animals into your home?
Let's move along. I know Lester's got a call coming up here. What the hell else do we have to... Let's do things that I saw on Twitter.
Freaky pigs, strange chicks, world affairs, polar bears, fake news, nice shoes, big boobs, jack dudes. All of these things and more as I sat on the shitter. Things that I saw on Twitter.
We usually do goofy stuff here, but Stoff is great to point out the fact that Super Bowl winner Laurent Duvernay-Tardif, who joined us on the field, probably my highlight of Super Bowl after the Niners lost, was having that guy with us, you know, awesome Canadian who's going to be a doctor someday, but right now he's a Super Bowl champion. And the joy on his face doing that post-game interview after they just won the Super Bowl was just unbelievable. Anyway, he's using his medical doctorate, and he's come back in the offseason and is on the front line fighting against coronavirus in Quebec, which is unbelievable. So Laurent Duvernay-Tardif, you know what? I'm going to try and get him on either on the pod or on do one of the interviews for SportsCenter, because we should do that for sure.
Big time salute to him.
They continue to try to kill time in Europe. This is a guy doing Freddie Mercury on the balcony, doing I Want to Break Free.
I want to break free.
He's a little A little bit of a pudge there for Freddie, but not a bad effort.
It's the effort that counts.
For Freddie, if he'd lift, maybe live another 10 years or so, maybe, perhaps.
Yeah.
You know.
I'll get stuff. We'll tweet it out on our Rubber Boots account, but...
poor laid off the drugs.
People Sorry. Are... It's been great watching all these people be creative during their things.
One sec. How long before we're singing Twisted Sisters, we're not going to take it anymore?
You mean us or the world?
World, if this goes on.
Well, it's already happening, brother, in the MAGA states, as you know.
Yeah, but they're still pretty small gatherings. It's not like it's tens of thousands of people. It's like a few.
And by the way, I understand, especially people that need to work. Like we did a campaign for Hockey for the Homeless last week where I wore this t-shirt, say, stay the puck home. I'm sure you saw myself or Bob and these guys wearing them. And it's the right thing for everybody who can do it. And we want everybody to, because we want to eradicate this thing. But I do understand the blowback of people that don't have jobs and, you know, need to make a living or need their business to make a living. I get the frustration. I do get it. I mean, we all want to open this thing back up. So I don't think we should universally portray everybody who's angry with this thing as some sort of knob. It's just the certain degree that some people are doing it with our...
There are certain knobs out there, though.
There's definitely some knob. There's a knob factor involved in a lot of the people we're seeing.
100%.
But I understand.
Yeah, one guy in British Columbia or in Vancouver walking around, and he just looked like a total douchebag. Luckily, there was only about 9 people with him.
Yeah, it literally looked like he got to a stoplight, and he's like, oh, look at all of us protesting. It's like, no, they're waiting to get across the street.
I know. If a deer farts in a forest and nobody is around to hear it, does it make a sound? This is from the great Rex Chapman Twitter account. If you're not following Rex Chapman, probably the greatest Twitter account next to the Rubber Boots Twitter account on the Twitter. This is just a deer farting in the forest. You want to play that sound, Son? I don't know what else to do with it. Is it an overdub?
Like, I think it's an overdub. It's funny because you see the tail go up and then that large fart. That sounds like a pure overdub. There's no way deers fart like that.
Or do they? Got a lot of nature questions on the pod this week. Maybe should we get instead of a dream expert, a nature expert on? We can ask them...
Don't want the dream absurd.
Can those spiders eat snakes? Deadly spiders or snakes? Which is more dangerous in her house? Is it okay to smother a possum in your green bin?
Can cougars fly?
Can cougars fly? Is my puppy really a pig?
Is Puffy a good name for a dog?
So many questions we need answered this week.
Imagine your dog is actually a pig. That'd be amazing.
Be a great story. There's a legendary story, and I don't know if it's internet myth, but I would suspect it's possible that it's happened before. A lot of people go down to different places and adopt dogs. I've talked about in Turks and Caicos how they adopt potcakes, but in Mexico they adopt these little chihuahuas all the time, right? Little chihuahuas discarded on the side of the road in Mexico. And there was a long-running story that somebody brought home a chihuahua that they'd found in the dirt, and then they found out when it got home, they took it to the vet, and it was a rat.
Come on.
I want that
what
story
to be true.
I don't know that you could really not know the difference between a rat and a chihuahua. We'll have to ask our nature expert that we have on next week.
That's pretty wild.
But I really want that story to be true. We're going to cut it short this week. Lester's got a call to make. I got some things to do. Also, it's probably the only nice day of the week. We're taping early this week on Monday. And so Stoff will have this out for you by the middle of the week. Puffy, should I keep the hair? Like, today I had no TV responsibilities, so I just put the hair up really high just to show you guys exactly how high it's getting. Do you think that would pass on the television?
I love it. I'm actually going to cut, though, as soon as I get my clippers. I'm going to the wood.
Oh.
Right down. Shaving it down to the wood, eh?
Lester, wow. I think we should screenshot this because I think this is the sexiest you've ever looked on a pod, and that's saying a lot.
Yeah, we'll get that out there for sure.
One challenge for you all. I want you to all see if you can run faster than my kids. They just did 2-kilometer runs, and Barrett did it in 9:30, and Austin did it in 10:40.
What?
If you guys can beat their times for 2 kilometers.
What was it again? I lost my screen for a second. Hold on a second.
9:30 or 10:40? 2 kilometer runs.
9:30 or 10:40?
Yeah.
2K.
Uphill?
Yeah. Do we have to go hard out for that? No, I don't think so, right? 10:40.
Uphill, downhill?
I like cross country kind of thing. Like it can be hilly, but not super hills. Okay. You can run anywhere. Any 2K you want.
All right. Mm-hmm. I'll give it a shot. Gentlemen, have an awesome week. And to all our listeners, keep the puppy names coming. And Lester, I'll be over for massage as soon as quarantine is over.
It's good to know to have that option.
Wow, 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 wow.
Bring your own lotion. I'm out.
Stop. You're doing a fabulous job producing these every week.
Yeah.
They, if to our listeners, we make a lot of mistakes and Stop edits them out. Like, say, Puffy saying...
Edit point.
That will be out of his pod.
Say that. I just said...
Edit point.
Oh, I see.
Oh, so maybe you'll only have to edit out my part.
Or all of them.
Thanks for listening, everybody. We'll see you next week. Oh, and thanks to our friends at idrinkcoffee.com. I've been doing a terrible job with the sponsors lately. So, Waimara, idrinkcoffee.com. We still love you both. Talk to you.
Yeah, hey, look at that hair and that goatee coming in. Holy wow.
You could be in Wolverine.
Hugh Jackman.
Absolutely.
How do you like that? I'm trying to do Puffy hair.
That's awesome. Looks good, dude. Very f***able.
Hey. How are you? I got a question that I really want to ask you. Wait. Don't hang up. I need to know, so I'm gonna try and push my luck. Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? Are they purple, yellow, green, blue, black, or white? Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? And do you like the dunk tank at the fair? I know it's a little strange, my obsession with your choice of footwear in the rain. I know that you're on TV, but I need you to put your boots up on the desk for me. Are you wearing your Hawaii boots tonight? Are they purple, yellow, green, blue, black, or white? Are you wearing your Hawaii boots tonight? And do you like the dunk tank at the fair? This is the part they call the bridge, up which has water under it. With rubber boots you can wade in the water. Just don't fall in. Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? Are they purple, yellow, green, blue, black, or white? Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? And do you like a dunk tank at the fair?
Do you like the dunk tank
at the fair?
The dunk tank, the dunk tank
at the fair. Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? No, seriously. Are you wearing your rubber boots? Don't hang up, please. Somebody? Anyone?